Good afternoon, everybody, here from Villa Park. Still one of the finest places to come to play your football in the Premier League. It's Aston Villa versus Everton, the 200th meeting between the two clubs. Aston Villa, of course, have got an FA Cup final on the horizon. Ronny Goodlass alongside me. Will that distract them?
I think slightly, Dan, and I think they must get a win today, obviously, but I think with a cup final being there, but they must go out and win the game. I think ourselves are in fine form. It's just a game both managers want to win, and I think it'll be an attractive open game, which you can't usually say about some Premier League games. But I think today, you just can't rely on other teams. I think Villa have got to come out, be positive, but I think the performance we put in against Manchester United was absolutely fabulous. I really enjoyed it, not the results alone. I just think every single player put a shift in. I think, it was last season's form. I mean, just everything about it. And when you can do that against a side like Manchester United, we can do it against anybody. So hopefully we can carry that performance and results on and hopefully finish the season unbeaten.
How nice is it to see the Toffees top of the form league?
Absolutely fabulous. I mean, you look at it and, the old cliche again, small margins. I mean, if you look at how many points we've actually dropped this season where teams have maybe parked the bus and, the likes of Swansea and Hull and West Brom come to mind, that's just the home. The away games against. But when you get on a run that we're on, I think every team knows you're in a game when you play against Everton. And I just think the attractive football we played against Manchester United, and everyone just seems to have energy and chances created. But coming here today, with Ben Techie, I think it'll be the battle of the Belgian strikers. If Morales plays, it'll be good for me. I think he deserves a run out. But Benteke and Lukaku, I mean, top of the bill, isn't it? We know Pacquiao's fighting Mayweather, but those two today, so hopefully Romelu will come out on top. And I think, again, when you're playing against one of your sort of international teammates, you want to be out on top. So I think Romelu might have a few things up his sleeve, so hopefully he'll get on the score sheets. I've done him for first goal. And as you know, Darren, we have a bet. But hopefully today we'll come out on top. And as I say, keep that run going. We're absolutely fabulous. You said over, top of the form league. But if we can finish the game, really come out on top, and then the last few games really send everyone into the summer on a high note, I think that's all well and good. I think we'll get a few new faces in, but I think last week's performance has showed that, Everton Football Club are on the way up, not looking over our shoulders on the way down.
It's the beginning of May, Ronnie. Just look at the playing surface out there. That reminds me of the baseball ground in the 1970s, that.
Absolutely different class, isn't it? I mean, the snooker's on, and, you look at that surface. I mean, no excuses today. A little bit of a breeze out, but, if you can't play on that, you can't play football. And end of story. So hopefully today, we like getting it down. Villa are similar since Sherwood's come here. Maybe they get the ball up slightly quicker to the front, but they like to play positive football in the right way. So today, I hope it's not the kiss of death, but I can see goals today. Hopefully it's all in the Villa net, but I think it's going to be a really good game, and hopefully if we play half as good as we did last week as a team performance and individually, I think we'll come out on top, and I can't wait for the kickoff.
Let's all hope so. Let's hope Ronnie is correct. By the way, there's a two-page spread in this afternoon's match programme. It's a picture of Brian Little scoring the winning goal in the second replay. Ronnie knows what's coming. Of the 1977 League Cup final, Dadicott left it for Lawson. Lawson left it for Dadicott. Stranded on the left-hand side is Ronnie Goodlass. He should have stopped the cross in the first place. We kick off at 3 o'clock. Mark Clattenburg's the referee.